So now we have our mesh. You will see this information in the message window here. You don't need to worry about this. It's just information about the post algorithm that we used for our inflation mesh. So we can just X out of that and look at our mesh. If we go into statistics, we'll see that we have 362,000 elements. We can also add a mesh metric. Click on mesh metric and select orthogonal quality. And you can see your minimum quality, your maximum quality, and your average quality. You can also see all of this in a graph. And you can click on each bar and it will show you the quality of those of certain elements in your mesh. Now, we're going to add our named selections. So, we're going to take off our wireframe view. So first, make sure the face selection filter is on and select this front face here. Right click and select Create Named Selection. We're going to name this Near Side. Rotate. Select here the extrusion that we created in the geometry section. Right click again. I'm going to name this Far Side. Now select the back face of our flow domain. Right click, name selection, outlet. Our inlet will be our arc that we created. So select the arc, right click, name selection, inlet. Now we're going to name the sections of our wing. We want to have just one wing surface, so zoom in and select a face of the wing. Again, we're going to extend to limits to make sure that we've selected all faces. Right click, create named selection, and we can call this wing surface. Our last name selection will be our wing tip. To do this, zoom in to the wing, we want to select all the way back here. If you just rotate and zoom out, you can see the outline of the surface that we've selected. Right click, create named selection, and we can just call this wing tip. After this, you have all your name selections, and now we are ready to move on to the setup phase.